Hello students, I am Dr. Amol Rahane, welcomes you to the course Physics Principles and Applications for FYBSC Semester 1 Physics Paper 2. So we are studying 4th chapter, Sources of Electromagnetic Radiation. So in this lecture we will study electromagnetic spectrum and types of electromagnetic waves. So in this lecture we will study the electromagnetic spectrum and types of electromagnetic waves. So let us study what are electromagnetic waves. So electromagnetic waves or EM waves are waves that are created as a result of vibrations between an electric field and a magnetic field. In other words, electromagnetic waves are composed of oscillating magnetic and electric fields. So let us study the electromagnetic spectrum. So we know the various types of electromagnetic waves. They differ from each other in their wavelengths and frequencies. The frequency of an electromagnetic wave also determines its characteristics and uses. Higher frequency electromagnetic waves with more electromagnetic vibrations per second have more energy. Low frequency electromagnetic waves with longer wavelengths have less energy. The types of electromagnetic radiations are broadly classified into several classes. So this is the electromagnetic spectrum. So in this spectrum the various electromagnetic waves are given, right? So in this spectrum, so if we consider from gamma rays, right? So if we consider the wavelength, in terms of wavelength, so gamma rays having very small wavelengths, right? So these are the rays having very small wavelengths, and therefore these radiations, their frequency is very high, and hence they are very high energy radiations. That means they have more penetrating power than all the other radiations. Then comes the X-rays having wavelengths of the order of 10 raised to minus 10 meter, right? So of the order of few angstroms, right? And then comes the ultraviolet radiations, which are slightly higher wavelengths or longer wavelengths than the X-rays, right? In between the UV and IR there is a small band of wavelengths, and that small band we call it visible spectrum, because this spectrum is visible to our eyes, right? So this spectrum is visible to our eyes, and therefore we call it visible spectrum or visible light, right? See, above the visible light there comes the infrared radiation, right? And above the infrared radiation there comes the microwaves, and then radio waves, and then comes the long radio waves, right? That means the radio waves, they are having very smaller frequency, whereas the frequency of gamma rays is very high, and because of that the gamma rays are having very high energy, whereas the radio waves having low energy, right? So let us study the different types of electromagnetic waves. So we know the gamma radiation, then we know the X-ray radiation, then comes the ultraviolet radiation, then visible radiation, infrared radiation, microwave radiation and radio waves. So all these radiations are arranged in the form of increasing frequency or energy from bottom to top, right? So radio waves having very small frequency, hence small energy, right? Whereas gamma rays having very high frequency, and hence they are very high energy, right? The wavelength on the other hand is increasing in going from gamma radiation to radio waves. That means gamma radiation is having smallest wavelength, whereas radio waves are having very longer wavelengths, right? So we can see the ranges of wavelengths and frequencies in the electromagnetic spectrum in this table. As already discussed, the radio waves, they are having larger wavelengths, and these wavelengths are greater than 1 meter, and their frequency comes in the range of 3 kilohertz to 300 megahertz, right? Then microwaves are smaller wavelengths than that of the radio waves, and their wavelengths fall in the range of 1 millimeter to 1 meter, and their frequency is of the order of 300 megahertz to 300 gigahertz. Then comes the infrared radiation, which is having wavelengths of the order of 750 nanometer to 1 millimeter, right? And frequency of the order of 300 gigahertz to 400 terahertz. So visible radiation that we know is of the order of wavelengths 390 nanometer to 790 nanometer, and ultraviolet radiation that are having wavelengths of 10 nanometer to 400 nanometer, and X-rays having wavelengths of the order of 0.01 nanometer to 10 nanometers, and the gamma rays having wavelengths smaller than 0.1 nanometers, right? So let us now study the radio frequency radiation. So radio waves are lowest frequency portion of the electromagnetic spectrum, and they are designated as radio waves, right? So wavelengths within 1 meter to 100 kilometers, or frequencies within 300 megahertz to 3 kilohertz, right? And they are having subcategories AM and FM radio. So AM means amplitude modulation, and FM, that means frequency modulation. That these are the techniques used in the radio communication or radio broadcasting. So radio waves can be generated by natural sources such as lightning or astronomical phenomena, or by artificial sources such as broadcast, radio towers, cell phones, satellites and radars. So the Earth's atmosphere is mainly transparent to radio waves, except for layers of charged particles in the ionosphere which can reflect certain frequencies, right? So we know that different regions in our atmosphere, the ionosphere is the region where charged particles and their ions are there, and the radio waves, they will be reflected back from the ionosphere, and because of that we can use these radio waves for long distance communication, right? Because they will be reflected back from the ionosphere, and we can communicate for longer distances using this phenomenon. Radio waves are extremely widely used to transmit information across distances in radio communication systems such as radio broadcasting, television, two-way radios, mobile phones, communication satellites, and wireless networking. In a radio communication system, a radio frequency current is modulated with an information-bearing signal in a transmitter by varying the amplitude or frequency or phase and applied to an antenna. The radio waves carry the information across space to a receiver, where they are received by an antenna, and the information extracted by the demodulation in the receiver. Radio waves are also used for navigation in systems like GPS, that means global positioning system, एंड नेविगेशनल बीकॉन्स एंड लोकेटिंग डिस्टेंस ऑब्जेक्ट्स इन रेडियो लोकेशन एंड रडार. दे आर ऑल्सो यूज फॉर रिमोट कंट्रोल एंड फॉर इंडस्ट्रियल हीटिंग. द यूज ऑफ द रेडियो स्पेक्ट्रम इज स्ट्रिक्टली रेगुलेटेड बाय द गवर्नमेंट्स coordinated by a body called as the International Telecommunications Union, ITU, which allocates frequencies to different users for different uses. Stars, planets, and other cosmic bodies, they emit radio waves. That means the stars, planets, and cosmic bodies are the sources of radio waves. Radio waves are emitted and received by antennas which consist of conductors such as metal rods, resonators, right? In artificial generation of radio waves, an electronic device called as a transmitter generates an AC electric current which is applied to an antenna. The oscillating electrons in the antenna generate oscillating electric and magnetic fields that radiated away from the antenna as radio waves. In reception of radio waves, the oscillating electric and magnetic fields of a radio wave couple to the electrons in an antenna, pushing them back and forth, creating oscillating currents which are applied to a radio receiver. Let us study the next type of electromagnetic waves, that means microwaves. So microwaves, they fall in the range of wavelengths from 1 meter to 1 millimeter. Their frequencies is of the order of 300 megahertz to 300 gigahertz. The microwave region of the electromagnetic spectrum is generally considered to overlap with the highest frequency or the shortest wavelength radio waves. The prefix micro in microwave is meant to indicate the smaller wavelengths as compared to the waves used in typical radio broadcasting, and it doesn't mean that it is the shortest, right? So micro means not it is short, it is not shortest, but it is smaller than that of the radio waves, and therefore they are called as microwaves, right? Their wavelength ranging from 1 millimeter to 1 meter. They are also absorbed by polar molecules coupling to vibrational and rotational modes, resulting in bulk heating. And because of that, this technique, we use microwaves in microwave oven for cooking food, because the water molecules present in our food, they will be vibrated, and due to the vibrations of the water molecules, the heat will be produced, and this will result in the cooking of the food, right? Microwaves can penetrate into materials and deposit their energy below the surface. This effect is used to heat food in microwave ovens and for industrial heating. Microwaves are the main wavelengths used in radar and are used for satellite communications and wireless networking technologies such as Wi-Fi, although this is at intensity levels unable to cause thermal heating. The copper cables, transmission lines, which are used to carry lower frequency radio waves to antennas, have excessive power losses at microwave frequencies, and metal pipes called waveguides are used to carry them. Although at the low end of the band, the atmosphere is mainly transparent, at the upper end of the band, absorption of microwaves by atmospheric gases limits practical propagation distances to a few kilometers. So there is subdivision in the microwaves, right? So there are different regions of the microwaves. So first one is the ultra high frequency or UHF, then the super high frequency or SHF, and extremely high frequency, दैट इज EHF, ऑल दीज सब डिविजन्स दे आर हैविंग डिफरेंट प्रॉपर्टीज एंड डिफरेंट एप्लीकेशंस. सो अल्ट्रा हाई फ्रिक्वेंसी रेडिएशन दैट फॉल इन द फ्रिक्वेंसी रेंज ऑफ 300 मेगाहर्ट्ज टू 3 गीगाहर्ट्ज दे आर ऑल्सो नोन एज डेसीमीटर बैंड बिकॉज द वेवलेंस रेंज फ्रॉम 1 टू 10 डेसीमीटर्स और 10 सेंटीमीटर्स टू 1 मीटर राइट. दे आर यूज फॉर टेलीविजन ब्रॉडकास्टिंग कॉर्डलेस फोन्स वॉकी टॉकीज सैटेलाइट कम्युनिकेशन एंड न्यूमरस अदर एप्लीकेशंस. देन कम्स द सुपर हाई फ्रिक्वेंसी रेडिएशन विथ फ्रिक्वेंसीज रेंज ऑफ द ऑर्डर ऑफ 3 गीगाहर्ट्ज टू 30 गीगाहर्ट्ज. दिस बैंड ऑफ फ्रिक्वेंसीज इज नोन ऑल्सो एज द सेंटीमीटर बैंड बिकॉज द वेवलेंस रेंज फ्रॉम 10 टू 1 सेंटीमीटर्स. दिस फ्रिक्वेंसी रेंज इज यूज फॉर मोस्ट रडार ट्रांसमीटर्स माइक्रोवेव ओवन्स वायरलेस लैंस सेल फोन्स सैटेलाइट कम्युनिकेशन माइक्रोवेव रेडियो रिले लिंक्स एंड न्यूमरस शॉर्ट रेंज टेरेस्ट्रियल डाटा लिंक्स. देन कम्स द एक्सट्रीमली हाई फ्रिक्वेंसी रेडिएशन और EHF इज द हाइएस्ट माइक्रोवेव फ्रिक्वेंसी बैंड विथ द फ्रिक्वेंसी रेंज ऑफ द ऑर्डर ऑफ 30 to 300 गीगाहर्ट्ज. दिस फ्रिक्वेंसी रेंज करस्पॉन्ड्स टू अ वेवलेंथ रेंज ऑफ 10 to 1 मिलीमीटर सो इट इज समटाइम्स कॉल्ड एज मिलीमीटर बैंड. दिस बैंड इज कॉमनली यूज इन रेडियो एस्ट्रोनॉमी एंड रिमोट सेंसिंग. लेट अस स्टडी द वेरियस सोर्सेस ऑफ माइक्रोवेव्स. सो माइक्रोवेव्स कैन बी प्रोड्यूस्ड बाय करंट्स इन माइक्रोस्कोपिक सर्किट्स एंड डिवाइसेस कंटेनिंग कैपेसिटर्स एंड इंडक्टर्स. माइक्रोवेव्स आर प्रोड्यूस्ड बाय स्पेशल वैक्यूम ट्यूब्स सच एज क्लिस्ट्रॉन्स मैग्नेट्रॉन्स एंड गन डायोड्स. फॉर ट्रांसमिटिंग एंड रिसीविंग माइक्रोवेव्स द साइज ऑफ द एंटेना मस्ट बी बिलो 1 मीटर दैट मीन्स of the size of the wavelength of the microwaves, right? Microwaves can also be produced by atoms and molecules. For example, they are a component of electromagnetic radiation generated by thermal agitation. The thermal motion of atoms and molecules in any object at a temperature above absolute zero causes them to emit and absorb radiation. The sun also emits microwave radiation, although most of it is blocked by Earth's atmosphere. The cosmic microwave background radiation, CMBR, is microwave radiation that permeates all of space, and its discovery supports the Big Bang theory of the origin of the universe. So, in the today's lecture, we have studied the electromagnetic spectrum in detail. We have studied different types of electromagnetic waves. We have also studied the radio waves and their various sources. We have also studied the microwaves and their sources. In the next lecture, we will study the next radiations, that means infrared radiation, visible radiation, and ultraviolet radiations and their sources. Thank you.